Hello YouTube, welcome back to my channel. Thank you very much for coming here. Thank you for all of you who have come here today to talk again about helmets, medieval helmets. Today we're going to talk about one of my favorite pieces of armor, or head armor, and that is the mail coif. Okay, so first of all, as I said, this is one of my favorites because it really reminds me of all those films and maybe early video games that I've played when I was younger. You know, films such as Robin Hood and all these things. Because basically, this is a piece of head armor, head protection, which was used mostly in the early Middle Ages. So we're talking about high Middle Ages, okay? Because at the end of the day, chainmail has been used for a very long time. It was used even at the time of the Romans, and I will talk about more specifically about chainmail as a full armor. But today we'll just focus on the mail coif. Now, first of all, first things first, let's talk about the actual name. So, mail coif. Obviously, mail stands for chainmail, and this is what this is. We have a lot of small rings, okay, interlocked into a pattern to form a mesh. All right, and there are several possible shapes for the rings, slightly different, revetted ones, not revetted ones, there are padded ones, there are quite a few. But at the end of the day, this is the most, perhaps the most standard version that you could have as when we talk about a mail coif. Now, talking about coif, in order to understand what that means, a coif was basically a hood, kind of, well, a cap, a closely fitted cap. And normally, coifs were well worn by both men and women in the Middle Ages, and they were normal headwear. We're not talking about armors. Mail coif is a piece of armor, and normal coif is not, because you would normally make it of white linen, probably, because it would keep you warm at night. So they would use it to sleep, for example, but also for your daily activities, to go out. It was quite wide popular, and it became less popular and old-fashioned around the 17th century. Now that's for the coif, but the mail coif was used also throughout the whole High Middle Ages. It kept on being used also afterwards, even when plate helmets were implemented, because you could easily wear a plate helmet over this, okay? So, in itself, it's already quite a good piece of protection. But then again, with the aid of a plate helmet, you would get basically a double dose protection. And so that's what most knights would do. And as I said, this is one of the things this is one of the ways that knights use these things. They use them not really as a main protection device, not really as a main protection thing, but mostly like a buffer, okay? To be put in between the knight's body and the plate armor. So weight is definitely one of the advantages of this helmet, of this kind of, well, not really helmet, this kind of head protection, because it is heavy, since the, as I said, the rings are metal, but it's not as heavy as plate helmets, okay, like the ones I've showed in the other videos I've made. And so for someone who would rather prefer a rather less heavy form, a lighter form of protection for the head, this would be a good choice. And also, another important thing about this helmet is the fact that you have perfect ventilation, perfect vision, and these are all advantages, obviously. But, as you can see, the face wouldn't really be protected. So this is the mail coif. Now, during the times of the Celts, or the Celts, as you prefer to pronounce it, they already appeared, and we have archaeological evidence, of aventails. Now, what an aventail is, basically, is only this part of the chainmail, of the mail coif, without the top part. Because you would already have a plate helmet, like the Norman helmet, for example, or the Celts helmets, to which this part here would be attached. Okay. Now, why would you do that? Because that way it would be lighter. Okay, and you would have very good protection of your head. And the aventail eventually replaced the mail coif in the 15th century, although occasionally it would still be used by footmen, soldiers and other troops. So, as far as I'm concerned, I rather prefer the mail coif for the looks than the Aventail. I don't particularly like the Aventail, but I understand the concept behind it. And also, another thing I'd like to say is that there were two different kinds, well, many different kinds, but two main different kinds. And these were the one which would be a little more loose, so it would cover you up to here, and another one which would cover you up to here. Okay, this one here is a bit in between, it kind of reaches my chin. But we know through medieval iconography that there were some kinds of male coif and aventails that would cover the wearer's face up to the just underneath the lip. And that is the main problem with these ones, that your face is in danger. So that's one of the reasons why it would often be used together with a helmet, a plate helmet, like for example in the case of the Normans with a nasal helmet, which I will talk about in that video. Now, as far as these helmets are concerned, you can find them in the internet quite easily. You can even find them for 50 euros, up to 300 and 400 euros, for these male coifs, I mean. And because this is not really a helmet. But again, the idea is the same, the general idea is going to be the same, but obviously the materials used are going to differ. Now, in my case, this is steel, so this is quite heavy, but it's good historical reproduction. But you have some people who prefer, for historical enhancements, who prefer to have these made of aluminium. Now, that's going to be really, really light. As a matter of fact, you wouldn't even notice wearing it throughout the whole day. It would weigh like feathers, so it would be good. But it wouldn't really be a good historical reproduction because, you know, a male coif made of aluminium would be very, very brittle, and that wouldn't make sense. And that was one of the reasons why, historically speaking, chainmail in general, male coifs as well and aventails, would be rather expensive because you needed to make sure to have good mobility, but also sturdiness. I know, as I said, brittle rings would break and would be pierced by spears, lances and arrows. All right then, it is wearing time now.
Als der Abend sich stillegte auf die Wälder, auf die Höhe, stand allein ich an der Klippe, hab ins tiefe Tal gesehen. Nebelstreifen, die Gespenster, wie ihr tanzen Abendglot, angetaucht im letzten Schein der Sonne, Glanz wie Blut so rot. Legten still sich auf die Bäume und umschlangen sanft das Gras, wie ein Zauberband, der wirkte, dass die Welt die Zeit vergaß. Und mein Blick war schon gefangen, als ich selbst noch nicht vernahm, dass ein stilles, leises Raunen aus den Nebeln zu mir kam.
Yes, as I said, this one here is quite fitting, well fitting, so it's not too loose. I like this one. Vision, perfect ventilation, even my voice, it's okay. My hearing is perfect. Absolutely, I'm losing absolutely nothing because obviously you have rings, so it's all filled with holes, so no problem with that. And as we said, I could easily put on another helmet to increase protection if I wanted to, even hold it here like this and then wear it in a situation where I really needed to. So I think this helmet would have been good not only for knights but also for foot soldiers, archers, crossbowmen and anything really. Mobility, vision, all these things are good about this helmet. Protection, frontal protection, not really, so it really needs on what you were going to do, strategy. Alright, well I hope you enjoyed this video. Please, if you did, make sure to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more videos about medieval warfare, armors and weapons. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Als der Abend sich stilllegte auf die Wälder, auf die Höhe, stand allein ich an der Klippe, hab ins tiefe Tal gesehen, Nebelstreifen liegen.